The Sorting Hat, as many, if not all of us know, well, I'm going to assume without question we all know what it does, is the magically enchanted hat that sorts new Hogwarts students into their houses. The sorting ceremony is held at the beginning of the year, where the newly sorted students will join their houses. But with that being said, the question has been asked so many times, and seeing as it's in the title of this video, I'll ask it now. Is the sorting ceremony held at the wrong time? Well, in today's video, I'm going to talk about the whole ordeal with sorting new students and my reasons for it to maybe, possibly, see a change to a different time within the year. Stick around, guys. Today's video is not a video to be missed. Okay everyone, so we know that the sorting ceremony begins shortly after the Hogwarts first years arrive on the grounds. Now, these students are 11 years of age, close to 12, with very little to no life experience, and will be sorted on the traits they value and believe in. Now, my first question is, at that age, do these kids really know what true bravery is? What ambition and cunning is? What true loyalty or true wisdom is? Now, for me, personally, I don't believe they can be sorted based on valuing something that they don't truly understand. Now, I know the hat tries to choose the right house based on potential, on what it feels is the best environment for the student in question, but it's quite an overwhelming time for the students. They are taking in their new surroundings and preparing themselves for the next couple of years learning magic, meaning that the house they are sorted into will be very important. Therefore, is it wise to sort the students so early? I believe the students should not be sorted immediately. I think they need the experience of the first year at the very least to understand and, more importantly, display some of the traits that each of the potential houses represent. Minds can change, opinions can change. Remember, it's based only on potential that students are sorted. We've seen that with the likes of Peter Pettigrew, for example. He had the potential for bravery and courage because he wanted to be like his friends. Not that he genuinely valued the traits. He was way more cunning than he was given credit for, and would have been much better as a Slytherin. So the Sorting Hat has got it wrong on occasions. And let's even look at Neville Longbottom too. He believed he was best suited to Hufflepuff because he was timid, he knew that, but he was humble and he didn't want to be on the front line. He did value loyalty and hard work, and it was only in his final act of the year of the book that he showed his courage to stand up to his friends for the good of his house, as Harry and Ron and Hermione kept causing the house to lose points. Now, if you ask me, that was actually him showing loyalty to his house, not courage or bravery. I think Neville would have made a very good Hufflepuff too, but he was suited to Gryffindor as well. Sorting students later on in the year, or even at the end of the year, would also prevent hat stalls, where the hat struggles to decide what house is best suited to the student. Minerva McGonagall, for example, a well-known hat stall lasting for over 5 minutes, was on the brink of being a Ravenclaw before the hat slightly leaned towards Gryffindor, believing she was best suited to the lines of Gryffindor Tower. Had the ceremony took place later in the year, Minerva would have displayed the traits best suited with either Gryffindor or Ravenclaw, or even spoke herself about the traits of which house she admired more from her experiences with students and teachers from either house. And that brings up my next point. Shouldn't the students have a choice themselves? What if they could take the time to research the four houses, the founders, and really and thoroughly understand what each house represents, dividing their time equally between living in the quarters of Gryffindor Tower, Ravenclaw Tower, the Hufflepuff basement, and the Slytherin dungeon before the end of the year commenced, making an adequate and well-thought decision on what house they would prefer to join, while still respecting that the Sorting Hat makes the final decision? I think personally that would be the best way to approach sorting. I've also read that some fans have suggested that there should be a resorting at the end of the year after the original one the previous September, which isn't a bad idea. However, my issue is the students will be settled in their houses, having made friends, becoming comfortable with the heads of houses, and I feel like uprooting them after a year is only going to negatively affect them. The rotation between houses is a better plan if you ask me. It will be a cool idea if the students could also be magically tracked on each trade they display over the course of the school year, which could be tallied up by the Sorting Hat when making the final decision on which house to place each student in. I think that's more a practical approach as well. But anyway, everyone, with that being said, that is my take on the Sorting Hat and the Sorting Ceremony, but I want you to let me know what you think of this ceremony in the comments section below. Should the Sorting Ceremony take place at a different time throughout the year? Let me know. Thanks again for watching, everyone, and please have a great day.